I'm Raleen Marks. This is the Israel Brief brought to you by Lay of the Land, where we take a look at those top stories making headlines every Monday to Thursday. So let's begin with some high praise to some well-deserving candidates. All of Israel is proud of you. These were the words of Prime Minister Netanyahu to the returning team of IDF Home Front Command who touched down at Ben Gurion Airport. Now, rescue teams from around the world have wrapped up their rescue and recovery efforts after the earthquake in Turkey and have returned to their respective countries, including the IDF delegation and those NGOs and other organizations that went with it during Operation Olive Branch. Now, the Turkish ambassador was present at the ceremony and expressed his country's thanks and gave Colonel Golan Vach, the commander of Israel's national rescue team, a bunch of flowers to express his country's gratitude. Now, Israel's field hospital will continue to be operational in the wake of the earthquake, providing much needed medical assistance to those who need it on the ground. Today, Israel's Foreign Minister Eli Cohen is undertaking a one-day solidarity visit to Turkey. He will meet with his counterpart Cavusoglu as well as President Erdogan. Both will express their thanks and gratitude for all of Israel's efforts. Israel had the second largest delegation of search and rescue personnel on the ground, second only to Azerbaijan, which neighbors Turkey. Now, the foreign minister and the president are expected to express their thank yous, and Foreign Minister Cohen is expected to express his condolences for the loss of life as a result of the devastating quakes. He will then tour the field hospital and has assured Turkey that Israel will continue to send humanitarian aid. Yesterday, two terror attacks occurred literally within a couple of hours of each other and were both carried out by 13-year-old Palestinians. The first one took place in the old city of Jerusalem. A 13-year-old stabbed an Israeli man, lightly injuring him. He is believed to be in stable condition. The 13-year-old Palestinian was then arrested by Israeli police. The second incident occurred close to Shuafat, where border guard was checking the entries at a checkpoint when a 13-year-old Palestinian stabbed him. A civilian police guard opened fire trying to hit the 13-year-old, but unfortunately hit Staff Sergeant Asil Sawad, just 22 years old. He died later as a result of his wounds. The 13-year-old was uninjured and was arrested by police. Hamas have appealed to the teenagers as young as 13 to carry out acts of terror against Israelis. Now, if anybody can't see that as abject child abuse, there is something seriously wrong. Former Prime Minister Naftali Bennett has weighed in on Israel's proposed judicial reforms. He has called this the most dangerous moment in Israel's history and cautioned that there should not be an exchange from one extreme to the other. The former Prime Minister also called for a pause in the planned proposal, saying that he really agrees with President Herzog's five-point plan. And last night, the Justice Ministry offered talks to Israel's opposition. However, opposition leader Yair Lapid said that they will not engage in talks until the legislation is stopped. And just to reiterate, nobody is saying that there shouldn't be reforms. There are grave concerns that perhaps the Supreme Court maybe is too left-leaning and exclusive or not diverse enough. But the overhauls that have been proposed are seen to be more extreme to the right. So the president is looking for some kind of compromise that sits in the middle and retains the independence of Israel's judiciary. Yesterday, hundreds of thousands of Israelis demonstrated across the country from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, where there was an estimated 300,000, to other cities across the country. And back to Turkey again, and Foreign Minister Eli Cohen, in a press conference in the capital Ankara earlier today, said that Israel is ready to resume direct flights to Turkey as soon as Thursday. He said that last year 800,000 Israelis had visited Turkey and that he expects this number to exceed 1 million. The foreign minister also stressed that ties between the two countries are only going to grow stronger in the next couple of years. So those are our top stories. Don't forget to check out our website at www.layoftheland.online, our Facebook page at Lotl Site. Like us, follow us, share our content. We are also on YouTube at The Israel Brief. Please click on that red subscribe button. And we are on Twitter at Lay of the Land 5. I'm Raleen Marks. This is The Israel Brief, and we'll check in with each other tomorrow for your top stories.